This is a tale of the supernatural. It's the work of a man who wrote ghost stories as a sideline. The author, M.R. James, was an archaeologist, medieval historian, and a great expert on the early history of the Bible. He was vice chancellor at Cambridge University during the First World War, and later became the provost of Eton, where he died in 1936. He's best known for his ghost stories, all of which have a peculiar atmosphere of cranky scholarship. The darkest of them is called Whistle and I'll Come to You. It's a story of solitude and terror, and it has a moral too. It hints at the dangers of intellectual pride and shows how a man's reason can be overthrown when he fails to acknowledge those forces inside himself which he simply cannot understand.
Professor Phil?
Yes, sir.
Sure.
All
anybody there? Anybody there? Professor Parkin, I telephoned to you from Cambridge. Booked here for a week.
On the registry?
Oh, yes, of course.
Coming for the golf, I suppose.
No, I'm afraid I don't play golf.
Oh.
Very much. If at all. Yeah.
At all.
About my...
Bring him in.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Been good here?
Aye.
The weather?
Oh.
At 8 o'clock, dinner, yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bread.
Turn down your bed, sir.
Turn down the bed. Turn down the bed. Yes.
Turn down the bed.
I think a little haddock. Come in, miss.
Quite sure you wouldn't care for a round after all, Professor?
No, I don't think I will. I'm going to go for a good trudge around the district. Mm-hmm. Take a packed lunch, perhaps. Dunes, beach, cemetery.
Oh, a bit too spooky for me.
Spooky? Is it? Spooky.
bone. Find those keepers.
Do you believe in ghosts, Professor?
Ghosts? That's rather a sticky one, isn't it? I'm not quite certain what you mean. I mean, I'm never quite certain what I'm being invited to believe when anybody asks me a question like that. I'm not even quite certain what I'm being invited to disbelieve when it comes to that.
I'm quite with you, old chap.
No, well, I mean, you ask me, do I believe in, say, Australia? Well, I know perfectly well what sort of thing I'm being asked to judge. I mean, you all agree what we mean by Australia. Large continent, southern hemisphere, discovered by Captain Cook, 4 or 5 large cities, kangaroos, and so on and so on. And given that, one can perfectly well imagine the sort of procedure that one might put in hand to confirm or, on the other hand, to disconfirm its existence. It's not quite the same thing with ghosts, is it? I mean, there's no broad consensus about what a ghost is there?
You owe me a bit of a chime on that one. Let's think now. Ghosts. The spirits of the dead. The survival of the human personality.
Survival of the human personality. Well, now, that's a different question again, really. And it has the grammatical appearance of a real question, but I wonder, does it really mean anything either? On the jury? Well, let's see. We say, for the sake of argument, that the human personality survives death. Right?
Right.
Well, now, but would we say it in the same way that we might say, for example, that someone survived a train crash?
Yes.
No, but would we?
Yes.
Would we, you see? I mean, we say, don't we, that Pausanias survived the train crash, but was very badly injured by it. Now, we wouldn't want to say that Pausanias survived death, but was very badly injured by it. Would we? I mean, we wouldn't want to say that. Would we?
No.
Well, clearly here we have a logical difference of usage, in that death, in a sense, is not like other physical catastrophes. I mean, one doesn't talk about anyone being very badly hurt by death. Come on. Except possibly the relatives of the deceased. But never the victim himself. Excluding, of course, the special interpretation in which one might say that he had been injured fatally by death. Or for that matter, that she had.
True. But there are more things in heaven and earth than in your philosophy.
I prefer to put it a different way. There are more things in philosophy than are dreamt of in heaven and earth. More things in heaven and earth. Delicious breakfast. Now, what have we got?
This who is coming.
Thank you. Parkin.
Yes.
Where shall I put the blanket, sir?
Where?
Well, which bed do you want it on, sir?
Which bed? Yes, my bed. Well, my bed.
Well, which is your bed, sir? You seem to have slept in them both. They're both rumpled.
Both?
But didn't you notice that both beds have been slept in, sir?
No, madam, I did not.
But it's ridiculous. I can't understand why you didn't notice it, sir. Perhaps you moved from one bed to the other in the middle of the night.
The habit of moving from one bed to the other in the middle of the night. Rumpled, it certainly is, yes. Rumpled. I've not been in the room since breakfast. Has anyone else got keys?
Oh, only we two, sir, and yourself.
Phenomenon.
Well, I'll leave you to straighten up. Your little, if true, demonstrates mind without brain and intelligence disconnected from what is termed a material body. It demonstrates that the so-called dead are still alive and that our friends are still with us though unseen. Present article may be taken as a denial of these theses, and surely could.
Who is this? Who is coming?
Thank you.
Oh, no.